Hey guys, we got us a no cooling call today. Let's see what's going on.
Flip it back on, see what happens.
Have to turn it down.
Yeah.
Let me get over here to that closet real quick. All right, I just heard it come on.
Yeah. Or sort of, I heard the refrigerant start flowing. Yeah, I hear it running outside, but not in here. Forgive me, I got somebody trying to call me back to back to back. Huh? They just gonna have to wait.
Basically, what is that? Bad news or don't really know?
We don't know. It could be the blower motor, it could be a capacitor.
But you think it's probably one of those too? I mean, we know something's wrong if the fan's not turning on.
Yeah, the fan is not coming on.
Do you keep capacitors in your truck?
Oh, yeah. Could be a relay or something like that. I mean, that twisting right now is hurting me.
You take some out? You want some ibuprofen?
No, thank you. I took some, something for nerve pain, but I'll say this is all.
Oh, what? There, you're missing one.
Yeah, I am.
Well, that loosened it up.
Let me get this out. All right, let me. I'm gonna go ahead and open this.
Stuff out of your way, Curtis.
Oh, you're good.
You been busy?
Yes.
This time of year, everybody's getting their air conditioners back on, and this.
I'm gonna tell you, I had a couple PMs or preventive maintenances scheduled for the day, but because my back's hurting so bad, I just kind of postponed until next week.
And where is the pan for this, the overflow pan?
You don't have an overflow pan, like an emergency drain pan?
Right.
This black plastic you see right here is the outside part of your drain pan, which is
okay. So there is a drain pan in there.
There is a drain pan in here.
All right,
let's see. What first I want to make sure you're getting a call for your fan to come on. Speed. All right, I gotta look at these a little closer to make sure I'm getting on the right one. Green is actually over here. I gotta get a light. I got one right here. Okay, that's green and red. Looks like that That right there.
I'll hold that.
Yeah, that works. All right, we are getting a call for the fan to come on. But clearly ain't nothing working. It's got us a variable speed. I got a motor tester I gotta go get. Probably the motor, which is not a cheap thing. A variable speed motor, that's probably a at least $1,000 motor.
Ouch!
But it could also be that board, so I'm gonna get that tester, and that way I can know for sure. Okay. We know we're getting voltage.
That might be the motor then, right?
The motor's supposed to get voltage 24/7.
Okay.
That's just one of the first things we check. Yeah. This board up here, that's what I'm worried about, that board, because it's not showing any flashes or anything.
Well, earlier, that green light was on.
Up here?
Yeah. You must have, you unplugged that, that's what it did.
Because normally it should flash the, yeah, there we go. It has a CFM LED right next to it, and it should flash the number of CFMs that it's producing, and it's not flashing. All right, gotta find the, here we go, that's it right there. This is my red. All right, we got power. Adapter A. Is it? Nope, nothing's working.
It's not going to be a breaker or anything, is it?
No. Oh, yeah. I know that
when you said nothing's working, all of a sudden I'm like, okay.
No, the blower's not working.
Because the power's there.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
The blower's not working, so now I need to pull it out enough to test that motor and see if the motor's any good. Anything that is train related, I have to order, and it's probably at the very least 2 days.
Well, I mean, if it is, it is.
Go ahead and leave that out.
But the motor is a train motor, or can it be any motor?
This is a variable speed motor that is fed by this board, an OEM board. It's going to have to be a train motor unless we put in like a PSC motor, which is a lot cheaper, but by the time you end up putting in a relay and a capacitor.
With that being said, you just stick with the train. You got all the, you stick with you.
Right, so. Yeah, let me kill power real quick. All right. See if I can just pull this out a little bit. I am so stiff.
Did you ever have back spasms?
Oh my God, yes.
Crippled it for about 2 days.
Well, I had two of them last night. And I was trying so hard to be careful, and it's just, you know, just reaching off to the side or something, and boom.
And you just lock up.
Oh, I know, I have to get an extension and get over there. So I'm being real careful today.
If you need to lift something, just let me know.
Oh, no problem. I think I can slide this out enough where I can test that motor without having to pull it completely out. Sometimes we can just replace that. Mm-hmm. And even still, it's like $500, but. Mm-hmm. But let's. Let's set this to ohms. So far, so good. It's not shorted to ground. Now let's test these windings. 10.3. 10.27.
10.36. As long as those bearings are good, that motor should be good. So I think it's the module.
Can you, is there a way to test that on you?
No, well, that motor tester let me know it was either the
that
or the motor, and the motor checks out fine, so we pretty much know
it's that.
Yeah.
But how do you test that? Just for continuity on that?
No, I don't test these.
Okay.
Once I know that the motor is good,
uh-huh.
I know that.
You know it's that. Okay.
It's this. Mm-hmm.
But that's something you got to order, isn't it?
Yes, sir. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and put all this back together.
Guys, I cannot buy just the module on that one. I think it goes without saying that the motor costs about as much as an air handler does, the whole air handler. But we're going to be replacing a motor. I did give him a little bit of break on that motor because I can't see charging somebody like $1,600. But yeah, we'll be back to do a motor on that one. And by the way, I gotta mention, when it comes to Trane and Carrier products, that is their business model. They mark up the prices so high on their parts that when they go out of warranty, sometimes it's cheaper to just get a new system. That's what they want. They want to move big boxes. They want to sell new systems. They don't want to sell you a part, so they mark it up so high, it's ridiculous. And that's one reason I don't sell Carrier or Trane. I'll catch y'all on the next one.